I have given a brief history of the elements in the first part of the periodic table. The element that was first discovered by man was white phosphorus. Today, we will discuss the second part of the periodic table. Can you tell whose handwriting it is? In first part of the periodic table, we started with Dalton's idea about atom. This is signed by John Dalton. Atom cannot be seen with the naked eyes. But now what I am showing is a photograph of a strontium ion bound in a magnetic field. This photo was taken by David Nerlinger at the University of Oxford on 7th August in 2017. This is the first photograph of an ion. Here strontium ion is indicated with a red arrow. This is Karlsruhe University in Germany from 3rd to 5th September of 1860 is the golden time in the history of science. At that time, the world's first chemistry conference was held at Karlsruhe University. That is the first international conference of chemistry. The name of that congress is the Karlsruhe Congress. Three professors, as well as chemists of that university, namely Welgin, Kekule, and Birch, were convener of that conference. 127 chemists from 11 countries participated in the Karlsruhe Congress. But why am I talking about the Karlsruhe Congress in the discussion of the periodic table? At the time, communication and information supply system were not fast and easily available. Information about discovered elements with its properties as well as atomic masses were need to be recorded and preserved scientifically. Main objectives of the Karlsruhe Congress were: number one, systematic classification of elements was demanded, and number two, determining the atomic masses of those elements. Were elements classified prior to the Karlsruhe Congress? Yes. In 1789, a book named Traité élémentaire de chimie, or On the Preliminary Chemistry Contract, was published. The first book on modern chemistry, a class of 33 elements, was printed in that book. Elements were grouped into gases, metals, non-metals, earths, light, and caloric. Author is Antoine Lavoisier, the father of the modern chemistry. This is the first classification of elements. This is the photograph of the chemistry laboratory of Lavoisier. In 1808, John Dalton first gave symbols of 36 elements, and he also ordered those 36 elements according to chemical properties. He is John Dalton. In 1813, John Jacob Berzelius introduced symbols for 47 elements. These are alphabets of chemistry. In 1828, he developed a table of atomic masses of those 47 elements. The first electric battery was invented by Alessandro Volta in the year 1800. This is the picture of that battery named voltaic pile. He is Humphrey Davy. In 1810, using the voltaic pile, he conducted electrolysis of aqueous solutions of different compounds. By electrolysis, he isolated sodium, potassium, barium, strontium, calcium, and magnesium. In 1830, using the reducing property of carbon and potassium, Berzelius discovered selenium, silicon, zirconium, titanium, and thorium from its compounds. In the year 1859, Bunsen and Kirchhoff invented spectroscope by flame test, that is, by seeing the flame color, they discovered rubidium and cesium. In Latin, rubidus means red and cesius means blue. So they named these elements as rubidium, as it gives red color, and cesium because of its blue flame in 1861. This is the spectroscope invented by Bunsen and Kirchhoff in 1859. Actually, investigating spectral lines, many new elements were discovered, practically rare earths. During 1815-1816, Prout said hydrogen is the fundamental atom by which other atoms of other elements are formed. Also that he suggested that atomic weight of every element is an integer multiple of that of hydrogen atom. In 1829, Johann Wolfgang Doberiner classified some elements in a certain pattern and named triad. He selected a set of three elements having similarities in some chemical properties, and noticed that the atomic mass of the middle element is an average of atomic masses of other two elements. As for example, here as lithium, its atomic mass is 7. For potassium, it is 39. Average is 23. Also, atomic mass of sodium is 23. Here some other triads are shown, but this was rejected as it cannot explain all elements. In 1859, Dumas considered four elements, as triad, but this was also rejected due to incompleteness. Also, it was not followed by all elements. Practically, in 1862, this is the first periodic table that was prepared and developed in the year 1862 by Alexandre Emile Bouguer de Chargentua. And he suggested that the periodicity in properties of the elements are the periodic functions of its atomic weights. He placed elements in 16 spiral path around a cylinder, like a screw, keeping tellurium element at the middle, so that his periodic table was named as telluric screw or telluric helix. Due to complexity, it was unpopular and did not got recognition. In the year 1864, John Alexander Rein Newlands ordered 56 elements in order of atomic weights. He noticed that some chemical properties of the first element is repeated in the eighth element. He called it as law of octaves, like seven note in musical scale. Here lithium is repeated in sodium, beryllium, magnesium, boron, aluminium, such and such. But it was rejected mainly because it could not hold good for elements heavier than calcium. In 1868, Julius Lothar Meyer made a periodic table of 53 elements. Unfortunately, the table was misplaced by his publisher and was not appear until after Lothar Meyer's death in 1895. 1869, Dmitri Ivanovich Mendeleev, he was 30 years old. He was a professor of chemical technology in St. Petersburg University. He was requested by his principal to teach inorganic chemistry, but at the time there was no good books on inorganic chemistry. So he tried to write a good book on that. He made 63 curves writing symbols, name, atomic weight, and properties of 63 elements separately on each card. He was playing with all those 63 cards in different patterns to get a systematic analogy between 63 elements. Actually, he was searching the similarities in properties between those 63 elements all day and night. Like eat chemistry, drink chemistry, dream chemistry. In the morning of 17th February of 1869, he dreams that different elements are arranged in a certain way. Awakening, he immediately recorded in his diary, "I saw in a dream a table where all the elements fell into place as required." I am showing that page of the diary in my slide. This is the first periodic table of Mendeleev of 63 elements. This is the simplest form of that periodic table. This is the article printed on the research booklet where Mendeleev periodic table was published. The periodic table is specially shown by red marker. He is baby Mendeleev, born on 8th February in 1834 in Tobolsk city of Siberia, Russia. This is the room, study room of Dmitri Ivanovich Mendeleev. This is the room used by Mendeleev at St. Petersburg University. Mendeleev periodic table is laid at the main entrance to the Institute of Metrolog in St. Petersburg in honor of Mendeleev. Step today, it is the discussion. If the discussion helps you, then like it, share it, subscribe it, tell others to consult this. I am coming up with the third part of the periodic table very soon. Until then, goodbye.